Pendengar setia semuanya, seperti saya janjikan sesaat tadi bahwa saya akan mengadakan wawancara dengan seorang wanita yang mungkin sudah Anda kenal sebelumnya lewat video-videonya, lewat lagu-lagunya dan juga penampilannya di Sydney Maulid Concert dalam beberapa tahun terakhir ini. Nah, siapa lagi kalau bukan Iman Farrar? Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Baik Iman, bisa ceritakan sedikit tentang keadaannya, latar belakangnya, dan apa yang sedang Anda lakukan saat ini?
Pertama sekali, terima kasih kerana menjemput Iman hari ini bersama Warna-Warni Indonesia. Latar belakang Iman sebenarnya biasa saja. Sekarang Iman dan keluarga tinggal di Sydney, Australia, dan Iman pelajar di salah satu universiti di sini dalam bidang politik dan kebudayaan bangsa Arab. Iman juga menyanyi nasyid dalam bahasa Melayu, Inggeris dan bahasa Arab.
Masya Allah. Yeah. Selain sebagai pelajar di universitas, juga menyanyi Melayu, apalagi kegiatan Iman selain itu?
Selain belajar di universiti, Iman sekarang dalam proses menulis lagu, insyaAllah. Ada plan menarik untuk tahun ini. Tapi, Iman juga aktif dalam program bersama United Nations, volunteering dengan UN Youth, they call it. Kita orang debate, we have workshops. There's a lot, it's a lot of different things.
Masya Allah, Iman. Jadi, sangat-sangat sibuk sekali ya sepertinya kegiatan Iman saat ini ya. Subhanallah. Semoga Allah selalu memberikan kesehatan buat Iman.
Amin.
Dan juga
insya
semoga
Allah.
Iman sukses ya.
Amin, insyaAllah.
Kemudian juga Iman, ini menurut pendapat Iman ya, seberapa penting bagi wanita muslim untuk menggabungkan ilmu pengetahuan Islam dan ilmu pengetahuan lainnya di era teknologi dan globalisasi sekarang ini?
Okay, I hope you don't mind me answering this question in English.
Alright, I'm gonna try to translate it after this.
Okay. But to answer your question, of course, I think it's incredibly important for all of us to live our lives by what our religion teaches us. And technology definitely is not excluded from that. Social media, for example, is a very powerful tool if we use it correctly. And that goes for technology and globalization in general, because I think it's created this very unregulated dimension to the way we all communicate, obtain and share knowledge and opinions. And I think because of that, it's up to us and our conscience, guided by our religious knowledge, to differentiate what's right and wrong, and you know, what's religiously acceptable in our globalized world, because there are very few borders.
Jadi menurut Anda, pentingnya pengetahuan ilmu agama dalam menerapkan kehidupan di era globalisasi ini, supaya kita bisa membedakan atau bisa memahami batasan-batasan yang bisa kita lakukan dan tidak bisa kita lakukan. Demikian. Menurut Anda, peluang apa yang tersedia bagi seorang wanita muda seperti Iman Farrar di Australia untuk mendapatkan hasil secara maksimal di bidang yang Anda minati?
In terms of opportunities, it definitely depends on what you're interested in. And I can't pretend to know about every single opportunity that exists and that's currently available for people interested in different things. Don't say no to an opportunity because you don't think you're not good enough. Because the chances are that you are. So, you know, don't think that you're too different. Be confident, be yourself, and just because you're from the minority and your religion has become the topic of the day or the month or the year, or because you choose to cover yourself and wear the hijab, it doesn't mean they won't give you the opportunity. So it's about putting yourself out there. An opportunity to do something in politics, like I did youth parliament. Apply for it. You never know what's going to happen. You know, we can't forget that our rizq has already been determined by Allah.
That's right. It's already preordained.
Exactly.
Masya Allah. Iman, bisa cerita sedikit, kita berbicara lagi tentang masalah parlemen. Saya pernah dengar kalau Anda pernah menjadi seorang youth premier di New South Wales. Bisa cerita sedikit prosesnya mendapatkan predikat atau posisi tersebut?
One of my friends and my student representative council at school, the coordinator, she sent me a link and she was like, you know, this is something you should do. She saw potential. And so I thought, you know what, I'm just going to apply for this. And that really ignited my interest in politics and in the world around me. So I went to the training camp, and there, that's where you apply for the position of youth premier, which is the top position, which is mimicking the New South Wales parliamentary system.
MashaAllah.
And yeah, so I applied, and the next thing I know, I was elected. People voted for me, and I didn't expect anything. I suddenly got a call, and Elle, who was the coordinator at the time, she said, "Congratulations, you've just been elected as our youth premier." And so it went from there.
Kemudian Iman, untuk persembahan kemarin di Sydney Maulid Concert 2016 ya Iman, bisa cerita sedikit Iman bagaimana proses pembuatan lagunya, kemudian siapa yang memproduksi lagu tersebut hingga wow itu persembahan kemarin itu di multicultural, Iman, Masya Allah, it was spectacular.
So I was very honored again to be invited to perform at the Sydney Multicultural Maulid Concert this year. It's going so fast.
Yes.
The song was called Kasih Padamu.
Yep.
And it was originally sung by Hafiz Hamidun and written by Fitri Yahya. I'm sure some people have heard of the original and they've heard my version, and you'll realize that it sounds quite different.
Mm.
And that's because the instrumental was rearranged and produced by the very talented Adam Ali from Harmony Band. And it was a wonderful experience. He definitely made it a lot more upbeat and I'd say concert ready. You can, for the listeners here today, they can actually get the Maulid tracks on iTunes or Google Play.
True.
And if obviously if they have a smartphone, and if they're feeling a bit more traditional, they can get a good old CD from 2MFM here in Sydney.
Mm-hmm. And how did you feel, Iman? Bagaimana perasaan Iman kala itu bisa bekerja sama dengan seorang maestro musik yang sudah cukup terkenal?
Masya Allah, he's incredibly talented.
Iman, could you please now please sing us a bit any song that you would like to give it to us today, insyaAllah. Silakan, Iman.
Okay. لو كان بيننا الحبيب لدنا القاضي والقريب من طيبة قبل المغيب طالبا قرب الحبيب بقربه النفس تطيب فتدعو الله فيجيب أنوار طه لا تغيب بلغنا لقاه يا مجيب.
Wow, Masya Allah kan. Bismillahi alaiki Iman Farar. Pendengar setia semua di rumah, tadi adalah suara langsung dari Iman Farar. Terima kasih Iman atas waktunya.
Barakallahu fiki.
Amin wa fiki. Kita jumpa lagi insya Allah Iman di lain waktu.
Barakallahu
fiki. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.